Hi, this is Venkat Narayana from Sonia Technologies. Today I am going to discuss boxing and unboxing in C#. This is continuation of previous video, part 14, type conversions in C#. Please go through previous video before going through this video. What is boxing? Boxing is a process of converting value type to the object type. Boxing is implicit conversion. For example, converting integer type to object type. Then that is called boxing. Later, unboxing. Unboxing is the process of extracting the value type from the object type. Unboxing is explicit conversion. Converting from object type to integer type, that is example for unboxing. Here, object contains integer type. If you want to convert object type to integer type, we need to convert explicitly using parentheses. Inside parentheses, we need to mention integer type. If you want to convert to double, then inside parentheses we need to mention double. Here, this diagram explains boxing and unboxing. Here we have stack memory and heap memory. Here we declare variable I and stored 123. This 123 directly stored into stack memory. In second step, we declare object O and assign it integer I. Here we are storing integer value into object O. This is called boxing. Here what will happen? 123 will not directly store it to object O. This object references to actual object that is located in heap memory. Here we have object. Inside object we have 123 value. If you want to get the value from this object, then we need to do unboxing. Here object O assigned to integer J. We need to convert explicitly. Here object contains integer type, so we need to convert to integer. Using parentheses, inside parentheses, we need to mention integer. This is boxing, converting value type to object type. This is unboxing, extract value type from object. We'll discuss boxing and unboxing using Visual Studio. Launch Visual Studio and create C# application. Here, I will declare one variable, int I is equal to 123. Now, I need to store this I value into object. Here, declare object variable. Object obj is equal to I. Here we are storing I variable into object. This is called boxing. Boxing is implicit conversion. That means no need to do anything. It will convert automatically from value type to object type. Later unboxing. We'll declare another variable int j equal to obj. We're getting error. What's the error? Cannot implicitly convert type object to int. An explicit conversion exists. Are you missing a cast? This is unboxing. Unboxing is explicit conversion. This object contains integer value, so we need to convert to integer. Here we need to cast. We need to do casting. Open parenthesis, close parenthesis, inside parenthesis. Here we need to mention integer. Now no error. We'll print the output. Console.println j equal to f0 placeholder comma j. We'll print I value also. Console.println here I equal to placeholder 0 comma I. We'll debug this program. Put breakpoint here. Go to debug. Click on start debugging RFI. Later click step into RF11. Start debugging. Here I am getting locals window. If you are not getting locals window, then go to debug, click on windows. Here locals window, click on locals. Locals window will be used to get local variables values. Here I variable. I variable is integer type. Default value for integers is 0. Here object obj. Type is object. Object is reference type. Default value for reference types is null. Here j. J is integer. Default value 0. Here we are assigning 123 into I variable. Now I is equal to 123. Later I value storing into object. Here observe here we have object. We are trying to store integer into object. This is called boxing. Here boxing happened. Now if you see here object, it contains 123. How it is? Like object of int. That means object contains integer type. And that value is 123. Now here unboxing. If you want to get the value from object, we need to convert explicitly. Here, inside parentheses, we need to mention integer. F11, now j contains 123. Now printing output I and j. Here output is I is equal to 123, j is equal to 123. This is boxing, this is unboxing. Now we'll discuss one more example. Here, this object contains integer type, so we are converting to integer. But by mistake, we mentioned short. This object contains integer type, but we are trying to convert to short. Now debug this program. Go to debug, click on start debugging, F11. Now object contains integer and value is 123. This is called boxing. Now we are doing unboxing. So at the time of doing unboxing, this object contains 123, this integer, but by mistake we mentioned short. So here we'll get runtime exception. Here we're getting runtime exception, unable to cast object of type system.int32 to type system.int16. That means if the object contains integer, then we need to convert to integer only. If the object contains double, we need to convert to double only. Here object contains integer, mention integer. Control F5. Now we don't have any error. We'll discuss one more example. Remove this code. Here int I is equal to 123. Later we are assigning I variable into object. This is called boxing. Here what I will do? I equal to 120. Let us print I value and object value. Console.write value of I equal to a placeholder 0 comma I. Console.write value of object obj equal to placeholder 0 comma obj. Put breakpoint here, go to debug, click on start debugging. First I declared I variable and assigned 123. Now I is equal to 123. Later I stored into object. Now object contains I and value is 123. Later what I am doing, I am changing the value of I. Here I is equal to 120. Here I value is changed. Now we'll see object value changed or not. F11. Now if you see the output, value of I is equal to 120, value of obj is equal to 123. That means once we assign value type to object type, then later if you change this value type, value of object will not be changed. Now we'll discuss one more example for boxing and unboxing. Create a list and store different types of values. List of object. Here list comes under system.collection.generic. So we need to use this namespace. Here lst values equal to new list of object. Now this list contains collection of objects. Object is the base type for any type in .NET. Now we can store different types of data inside list. If you want to add the data into list, here lst values dot add. Here first group. Now this list contains one string value. Later we'll add integer values using for loop. For int I equal to 1, I less than 4, I plus plus. Add this I values to list lst values dot add of I. Here I is integer. Here list contains strings and integers. If you want to print this output, here we'll use for each loop, for each. Here list of object storing different types of data. Object is a base type for any type in .NET. So object can store any type of data. Here, if you want to get the data, here we'll use var item in lst values console.writeline item. We'll execute this program, put breakpoint here, go to debug, click on start debugging. Here we created a list of object F11. If we expand this one, here list of values, count is equal to 0, type is system.collection.generic.list of objects. That means this list can store collection of objects. F11, we added string value. Here in 0th position, we have one string, that name is first group. here object of string. Later we are adding integer values. Here first position we have one F11. Here second position 2. Like that we'll add values. Third position 3. Here that list contains 4 values. One is 0th position first row, later 1, 2, 3. Now list contains different types of data. Here we are storing data into list of objects. So boxing is happening here. If you see this one, here object of string, object of int, object of int, object of int. So for these three, boxing is happening. If you want to get the data from object, unboxing will be happen. Here we mention as var item. We don't know what type of data we are getting from here. We can get strings or integers. So for that purpose, we'll mention var item. Here, if you get string value, var keyword act as string. If you get integer value, var keyword act as integer. F11. So here, first value is string. So var item. Now here, this one will act as string. Here, object of string. Later, here second item is integer. Now var act as a integer. Print output. Here 1, F11. Like that, we'll print output. The output is first group 1, 2, 3. What we understand from this program is, here we are storing different types of data inside list of object. At the time storing data into objects, boxing is happening. Later we are trying to get the data from object, so at that time unboxing will be happen. Here we'll write one more logic. What I can do, I need to multiply these I values. Here declare sum variable int sum equal to 0 for int I equal to 1, I less than 4, I plus plus. So if you want to get the values, we need to use this list. Here sum plus equal to LST values of, here LST values are list. We can use list, we can get the data from list just like arrays using index number. Here we need to pass index. Index is I. Multiply LST values of I. Here we are getting one error. What is the error? Operator multiplication cannot be applied to operands of type object and object. Here object contains address or reference. We can't multiply addresses. We need to multiply values. So here we are getting error. If you want to rectify this error, we need to do unboxing. How to do unboxing? This list of values of a contains integer, so we need to convert to integer. Here int, this is unboxing. Here also int. Now we don't have any error. We'll print sum. console.write sum equal to placeholder 0 comma sum. Now we'll debug this program. Go to debug, click on start debugging. F11. Here create object for list of object. Later add string value. LST values contains one string and name is first group. Later add integer values. Here first position we have 1, second position 2, third position 3. F11. Later we are getting values from list using for each. Here output is 1, 2, 3. Now we need to multiply those integer values and sum those values. For int I is equal to 1, 1 less than equal to 4, true. List of values of I, this one contains address. We need to get value from that address, then we need to do unboxing. Here right click on this one, quick watch. Here 1 and type is object of int. We need to unbox. So here we are unboxing. Here 1 into 1. Here sum is equal to 1. F11. Now I increment 1. I is equal to 2 less than 4. List of 2. List of 2 into list of 2. Here sum is equal to 5. F11. I is equal to 3. 3 less than 4. True. List values of 3 into list values 3. And sum is equal to 14. I is equal to 4, 4 less than 4, false, it exits from for loop and print the output. Here sum is 14, here sum is equal to 14 printed. What we understood from this one is, here this one contains address. We can't multiply addresses. If you want to multiply values in that address, then we need to unbox, later multiply those values. What we discuss in this video is, what is boxing, what is unboxing, how to do unboxing, and how to multiply values from the object. That's it for today. If you like this video, please share with your friends and subscribe to my YouTube channel for future videos. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.